गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द न्यू लेसन द क्वालिटीज ऑफ गुड सिटीजन. सो द लेसन हाईलाइट्स अबाउट द सिविक सेंस एंड द क्वालिटीज ऑफ द गुड सिटीजन्स. सो वी आर द मेंबर्स ऑफ अ सोसाइटी दैट वी लिव इन. वी ऑल आर द मेंबर्स ऑफ द सोसाइटी. Just like each family members has and responsibilities, has its roles and responsibilities to be to upkeep their families. Just like that, every members of the community has also has an obligation, that is duty, towards their community as well as country as a whole. So each member of a community also has an obligation. What do you mean by obligation? Obligation means duties. Okay, va? Obligation means duties. So just like each family members has an as a responsibilities to upkeep their families, just like each member of a community, that is we as a member of the community, had a certain obligation, that is duty towards our community as well as country, towards our community as well as country as a whole. So being a responsible citizen, contributing for the progress of our country. So being a responsible citizen, so if you are a responsible citizen, you must contribute for the progress of your country. Being a responsible citizen, contributes, it's a duty for our to contributes towards the progress of a country. So we are the members of the society. Each member of a community has an obligation, that is duties, towards our community as well as our country as a whole. So being a responsible citizen, if we are a responsible citizen, we have to contribute towards the progress of our country. Now we are going to see about what is civics and the importance of the civics. Okay, va? So as you know, people who live in a members of a particular country is known as citizen. People who live in a member of a particular country, is known as its citizen. So what is citizen? The people who live in a member of a particular country. So if we are a member of a country called India, so we are a citizen of India. So who live in a member of a particular country, we call that person is a citizen. Okay, va? They may live in any parts of India, or even they, or sometimes they may live in abroad also. Okay, va? The citizen, they may live in any parts of India, any parts of the country, or sometimes they may live in abroad. Abroad means in a foreign country. Okay, va? So this is about citizens. So people who live in a member of a particular country is known as citizen. They may live in any parts of our parts of the country, or sometimes they live in abroad. Now let's see what is known as citizenship. So what is meant by citizenship? The state of being a member of the society and have the rights to live, work, and having the and have the rights to vote in a country is known as citizenship. The state of being a member of a society. The state of being a member of a society and have a right to live, work, and vote in the country. Vote in the country are called as citizenship. So what is meant by citizenship? The state of being a member of the society and have the right to work, live, and vote in the country is known as citizenship. Okay, well, now let's what is civics means. So what is civics? So civics is a study of rules and duties of a citizen. So what is civics? Civics is a study of rules and duties of the rules and duties or the responsibilities of the citizen. Responsibilities of the citizen. So learning civics is important as it make aware of our rules and the duties. Learning civics is important as it make us aware of our rules and duties of a citizen. Civics also help us to know how the government is working. Okay, va? It also help us to know how the government is working in our lives. Our government is working. Basically, India is run by government. So it safeguards the duties and the rules and the duties of its citizen. So government safeguards the rules and the duties of its citizen. It is meant for the welfare and the benefits of its citizen. Government is meant for the welfare and the benefits of its citizen. So, what is civics? It is a study of rules and duties of a citizen. Learning civic is important as it make us aware of our rules and the duties of as a citizen. It help us to know how the government is working. India is run by the government. So government safeguards the rules and the duties of its citizen. It also meant for the welfare and the benefits of their citizen. In return, we the members of the community has some also have an responsibilities. In return, the member of the community also have an responsibilities. They also have to follow some rules and obligation. Follows the rules and obligations, and for the welfare of their. For the progress of their country, okay, ma? For the progress of the country. So, fulfilling all the needs and the responsibilities, the country is to be progress, okay, ma? So this is about what is meant by citizenship, the state of being a member of a society and have a right to live, work and vote in the country are called as citizenship. What is citizen? A member of the people of a particular country is known as citizen. He may live in any parts of the country, or sometimes they may live in a foreign country in abroad. And today next we have learned about civics. What is civics? It is a study of rules and duties of a citizen. Why it is important to us? Learning civic is important as it makes us aware of our rules and the duties of as a citizen. It also help us to know the role of the government. Okay, va? How government is working. India is mainly run by the government. It safeguards the rules and the duties of its citizen. It is meant for the welfare and the benefits of its citizen. So in return, the members of the community also have some responsibilities to follow some the rules and the obligations for the progress of the country. Okay, va? Now let's see. Now we are going to see what is civic sense. So what is civic sense? As we are living in a one community, we have some sense. We should not disturb the environment, we should not disturb the peace by littering or spitting on the roads. So these activities is known as civic sense. So as you know, humans are social being. They like to live in a group, not in a isolation. Isolation means taniya. So they like to live in a group because they mainly depend on each other to live comfortably and feel secure. Okay, va? They depend each other to live comfortably and feel secure. So people living together in a group is known as society. people living together in a group is known as society. So what is society? People living together in a group is known as society. So while living in a society, it is important for us to have an understanding of how to conduct oneself in public. So while living in a society, it is important to have an understanding to conduct oneself in public. So if you are living in a society, it is important how we are conduct, how we are talking with the other members. It should be very careful. Okay, if we, how we have to conduct in a safety manner, we have to speak them politely. We should not litter our environment. We should not disturb the peace of the others. So it is very important, if you are living in a society, it is very important of understanding to conduct oneself in public. Okay, va? So the many a times you can see that people are spitting on the road, littering the places. This all shows, this will make the surrounding, the environment unclean. These actions shows the lack of civic sense. The action also makes discomfort to others, and these are the actions known as civic sense. So let's see what that is. People spitting on the road, and littering other public places, these type of activities makes our surrounding unclean. It also causes discomfort among the other people. These actions of some human beings cause discomfort to the other people living in a community. Okay, va? So these type of actions shows a lack of civic sense in those people. Okay, va? These actions shows the lack of civic sense. Okay, va? So what is civic sense? As you know, humans are social beings. They like to live in a group, not in an isolation. They mainly depends on each other to live comfortably and feel secure. Okay, va? People living together in a group is known as society. So while living in a society, it is important to have an understanding to conduct oneself in public. So we can often see people spitting on the road, littering other public places. This makes our surrounding unclean, and this type of action also causes discomfort to the other people, and this shows the lack of civic sense among those people. Okay, va? Now we are going to see some of the examples of the lack of civic sense among the people around us. So some of the examples of the lack of civic sense among people around us. So what are the lack of civic sense you can see among the people? The first one, not waiting in a queue, just moving to the front, breaking the queue, not waiting for one's turn in a queue. Not waiting for one's turn in a queue, just moving forward, moving front, breaking a queue. So this is the one type of lack of sense civics you can see. You can lack breaking queue, lack of civic sense. This is the one way. And what is the second way? Spitting on the road. This is also a lack of civic sense. Spitting on the road. Littering. Third one, littering public places like parks and playground. Littering public places such as parks and playground. The fourth one, damaging public properties. Damaging public properties. Fifth lack of civic sense, breaking traffic rules. Breaking traffic rules. Sixth one, disturbing the public peace. Disturbing public peace. By hearing loud music, honking horn, horn of a vehicle unnecessarily. Third one, next, even talking loudly. So these are the some of the examples of the lack of civic sense we can see among the people around us. So once again, I just repeat the first one, not waiting for one's turn in a queue, moving front, breaking the queue. The second one, spitting on the road. The third one, littering public places such as parks and the playgrounds. Fourth one, damaging and destroying the public properties. Breaking traffic rules. Disturbing public peace by hearing loud music, honking horn of a vehicle unnecessarily, and talking loudly. These are all the examples of the lack of civic sense among the people. Okay, va? So this video we have seen about the civic sense. We have seen what is the role of the citizen, role of the government. So if you are having any doubt, you can ask me. In the next video, we will see about the qualities of the good citizen. So relating this topic, if you are having any doubt, you can ask me anytime. Thank you.